Happy birthday to me! And to celebrate, I am sharing with you some advice which appeared in HBR the year I was born in an article called Management Time, Who's Got the Monkey? In the piece, the authors visualise the monkey as a problem or an item on the to-do list, and they ask who's holding the monkey, which is also known as a sick monkey. Who's got the problem? And what they talk about is a team with a team leader where all of his team keep coming and giving him their sick monkeys to fix. So one comes in and says, I've got a problem with billing this client. And the manager or leader says, okay, let me have a look at that, send it over. Another says, my contact database, there's a problem in it. I can't find the contacts we need for this event. And the manager says, right, send that over. I'll have a look in my emails and see if I can find them. And a third one comes in and says, this line of code, it's just not working. And the manager says, don't worry, I know just the person to fix it. And at the end of the day, the manager or team leader is sat with this troop of sick monkeys, while everyone else goes off unable to get on with their jobs, potentially because he's the barrier to them then moving forwards. And in the article, they go off and play golf and he's still working all weekend. Now, all of that feels a bit out of date for our world, but all of us have the opportunity when we are given a sick monkey of somebody else's problem to decide what we can do. We can invest time in trying to make it better, trying to heal it. That might go well and it might turn out that we're a hero, at least briefly, but it probably also detracts us from whatever it was we were supposed to do that day.
Ow!
We can try and ignore the sick monkey because, you know, we've got other things we're supposed to do, and the monkey will get sicker, it'll feed on our conscience, it'll make us feel bad. And thirdly, we can either never get back to the monkey so that it dies, or we can fail in our mission to fix it and it'll die anyway, and then we're the ones with a bloody dead monkey sitting on our desks. So, what is the solution to the sick monkey scenario? Well, a friend of mine talks still very fondly about a boss called Mikey he had in his 20s. And at that time, he was a developer working internationally, and Mikey was a project manager. And he would walk the floors every day and say, hey, how are you getting on? And if you told him you had a problem, he would say, is it a big problem or a small problem? Now, if it was a small problem, Mikey would say, well, I'm sure you can resolve it. If it was a big problem, he'd say, that sounds tricky. What are you going to do about it? How do you plan to resolve it? And he would push that sick monkey back over the table. And then the person on the receiving end would go, well, I might need to call help desk. Or I think Jackie over there might know the answer and have dealt with this before. Or I'm going to reload it and see if that will work. And what was magical about this approach was actually it built trust with the team. They built their skills. They learned to be more responsible. And interestingly, given that he never really helped them, they loved Mikey. Now, Mikey also, apparently, was fantastic at buying ginormous rounds of beer on a Friday night. So the relationship with Mikey might have been more complicated. But what he did, which was amazing, was by never taking those monkeys, he was really good at doing his job, which was to protect the team from the pain in the ass clients, the calls, the deadlines, and all that stress. So they never had to deal with that. I hope that's helpful. I hope it's something else good that comes from 1974. Tell me your sick monkey strategies, your sick monkey stories. If this is new to you, if it's something you already knew, I look forward to hearing from you. And otherwise, I'll see you next week. Take care.